I did actually improve my qualifying time just a little bit. By just over a tenth of a second. But Rob improved by 6/10 of a second, and now he's on the pole.
Still line up behind the 12.
He was actually starting behind me on Thursday, and he really improved a lot. He must have learned something from Thursday's race.
Line up behind the 12.
Because he just had a ton of speed in qualifying today.
Line up behind the 12.
I'm going to try a slightly different pit stop strategy today. We're going to pit earlier. I think I screwed up because I stayed out too long last time, and that really hurt my chances of getting a decent finish because I lost too much track position after the pit stops, and I couldn't really get it back after that. So that led to a poor finish, comparatively, anyway, for me. Anyway, we got 55 more laps today and 55 more tomorrow night. So, let's do it right.
Fly back in your seat there, bud. Give those belts a good tug. Get a look at your steering wheel there. Make sure that thing's buttoned up right. Race cars in. Be ready. Green flag.
Gonna try to be a little bit easier to the car today. Not wheel hop so much, and try to not spin the tires so much either. That really hurt me.
Wait, what'd y'all think was coming?
On Thursday. Just gotta take it easy right now. Early days. Rob seems to be a bit nervous though. He's already made a few mistakes, going wide a couple times, spinning his tires a little bit. I'd really like to stop hitting that curb too. You might notice I'm taking a slightly different line through turn 11 too. I'm staying to the inside for quite a bit longer than I was on Thursday. I think it's a little bit faster. That was a bit sloppy. And that was a bit too wide. I gotta really try harder to not hop that curb out of turn 4. If you go wide there, that can cost you a lot of time through that little short chute there. Went a little wide there, too. That corner can be hard to set up for sometimes. I can't keep sliding like that. I'm just gonna kill the rear tires if I keep doing that. And Justin's starting to show some long run speed. I can see that. That was weird. I was pretty sure I lifted there, but it didn't shift. The gate, or rather the gear lever, was well into the gate there. That wasn't the issue. Had a pretty nice gap back to fourth, too. I'm not going to be worrying about them. Won't have to be doing much mirror driving as of now. So that's good. don't know, I just feel more calm today, too. I think that's helping me control the car a lot better, too. Not wheel hopping as much, not sliding around as much. So that's always good. Oops, went too wide there. Wasn't able to set up for turn two properly. I'd rather not hit that curb if I can help it. I might have said this already, but we're going to stop at lap 26. So we're going to be stopping quite a bit earlier than on Thursday. I think that'll help us keep our track position. Although having a 7-second lead to the next car will probably help more with keeping track position. We got really loose there at the top of the hill. I can definitely feel the rear tires are starting to go away. It's just sliding around quite a bit more now. Starting to catch some lappers. Goes again, the transmission not shifting. Still a pretty close race for the lead. Either one of those guys have a really good shot of winning. But as long as I can see them, I'm still in it too. Anything can happen, it's a long race. Guess something happened to Doug there. I don't know where he went. But he was running in fourth for a while. Only a few more laps to the stop, guys. Yeah, the rear tires just want to steer the car right now.
Your eyes open.
What are you doing?
Got that lap car up there. On your right.
Okay, got through that cleanly at least, but that cost me a little bit of time. A little scared because he wasn't really up to speed at all. When he came back on the track like that, but he at least held his line so I could get around him easily. Alright, two more laps. Alright, right here. I see Bolton also pitted. So I think this is the right strategy.
Pitting here, go.
Four tires and fuel. There's no reason to do anything else here. Alright, let's hope this is a good stop. I don't think it is. Yeah, slow stop. Very slow stop. 14.3, not good at all. I hope that'll allow Bolton to catch up a little bit, and maybe they'll battle for position there. Allowing me to catch up. Ah, jeez, what am I doing? Did that last time, too. There's no damage, though, again. Got off pretty lucky that time. Another sloppy corner.
Halfway.
Oh God, where are you going, dude? Guess he's gonna quit, that's where he's going.
There by half.
Taking it right here, Shane.
Well, at least I got clean air right now. I'm just gonna try to make the most of it. Hope Justin catches up to Rob and they wreck each other and I just drive by for the win. Because I'm not gonna catch him based on pace, that's pretty obvious. So, I'm just gonna have to hope that I get extremely lucky. Does anybody else see a rainbow in the skybox? Because I do. I know it's a weird thing to be thinking about right now. But I just noticed that and I had to say something. No, it's not gay marriage confirmed. Right there, you should see it. Well, that's where I saw it anyway. Oh boy, look at this gaggle of lap cars. This should be fun. Can't even see where the leaders are right now.
Let's bust this traffic, girl. Good job, man. left side. Clear.
It's funny how the only time these guys play nice, for the most part, is when we go to the road courses. Every other time, they're always in the way.
Put up, my man. Tell him you're on the way. Left side. Clear. Good job. Left side. Clear him.
Kevin looks like he's been in an incident or two also.
Thanks.
Judging by that
after, baby. I need 25
big scrape on his right side door anyway.
Thank you.
Lost a lot of time trying to get around those lappers compared to the leaders. Damn, went way too wide there. I keep thinking I'm gonna hit the wall, but I never do.
Right side. Clear, clear, clear.
Don't want to go off track.
That's safe.
Whew, thanks. Fourth place is nowhere in sight. It's probably going to be a pretty boring race from here on out. Unless I fuck up. Could always stay tuned for the fuck up.
Good job, man. Don't change your line. They're gonna move.
I hope so.
On your left. Clear.
Still a very close race for the lead, apparently, but I'm just falling further and further back. I'm gonna be like 15 seconds behind by the time this is over.
Thank you.
car is a lap down ahead of us. Left side. Still there. Still there. Where?
You're forcing the issue a bit there, but I gotta get around these guys. That's actually a really bad corner to set up a pass for. Because it's not wide at all, but he wasn't giving me any room to work with there. I got such a better run on him coming out of 3B, I didn't really have a choice there. About to go for that pass.
I mean, you saw me right there.
Oh, I saw you spin. I didn't see you coming as I was making a 180.
This voice chat's been really quiet today. Everybody's focusing on driving instead of running their mounts, I guess. For the most part. Balance feels pretty weird now. It's got this push-loose effect at the moment where I have to put too much wheel into it, right, and it gets loose because of that. Like, the front tires aren't gripping enough, but the rear tires are just dead.
Thank you. just about to let you go. I give a guy 1x and then he gives me a 4x, if that'll work. A 0x, rather.
Uh-oh. That's not good. I wonder if that was a why me.
Left side.
He just really wanted 22nd place.
I thought a guy really wants 16.
I think Rob made some sort of mistake. Bolton gained like half a second on him that lap. If they battle, you know, that's a good opportunity for them to take each other out and I could just drive on by. That would be epic. It's pretty unrealistic at this level of racing, though.
Take the next corner.
Sorry, Logan. I got pulled the cheap tire this week.
Oops. Those rear tires are just taking total control over the rest of the car right now. Becoming pretty hard to drive. Got some really bad rear steer going on right now.
Go.
Thanks.
Seriously, dude?
Only 5 to go. Once we cross the finish line, that is. There we go, 5 to go.
5 to go. is not a spot. He is not a spot.
Who? Come on, spotter. You gotta give me more info than that.
Hey, Peter.
I think I see the leaders up there, actually. Might be wrong.
Over here.
Yeah, I don't think those are the leaders. Those are probably two different cars fighting for position. Still a really close race for the lead, but I'm not going to be anywhere near them from the judge. From the looks of things, that's what I'm judging anyway. That's what I meant to say.
I'm working on them. Coming to the white flag this time.
Man, this has to be one of the quietest races I've had in a long time. I mean, I didn't get into any incidents, nothing really happened, there weren't any passes. Probably made for a pretty boring stream. I'll take a third place. I would have liked to have a more realistic shot to win, but you can't win them all. I guess.
careful then, Rod.
Thank you.
Good racing with you there, mate.
Alright, first top five of the week. That was not bad. I think I finished where I should have there. Oh, man.
Good job out there, driver. Good solid day. Great track for us next week. Yeah, girls with
tough race. Finished 15 seconds behind the leader. The winner, I should say. Not bad, but we got one more shot to try and get a win this week.
I didn't get into the thought of you there, did I?
Yeah, thanks, Jordan. I hope I gained some points out of that.
I'll try to pinch you.
We'll have to check the results.
Next half. It was an ugly pass, but it's fun.
0 incidents again is always nice too. I don't know what happened on the last lap when I was going into turn 2
I've been avoiding
the right front just hopped the curb.
Then I had came out.
Almost had an incident there. Well, I'll take that. That was a really good finish, even though it was a pretty boring race. I use a Logitech G27 breakthroughs, but I also have a GTI progressive brake spring, so it gives you a much heavier feel when you lay on it hard. It's a lot better than
all your
the
stuff,
stock brake
jacks,
spring.
Guns and all that stuff kind of packed up.
Oof. I was 20 seconds, or 21 seconds, rather, ahead of Tyler D. Hudson. That's the only time that'll happen, except for maybe Watkins Glen. I'm actually pretty pleased with the Logitech G27. I've had it for a while. The only time it's given me problems is when I didn't know how to set force feedback correctly, and I burned the encoder out. But I bought another one after that, and it's been smooth sailing ever since. That was like 2 years ago. I want to see what happened to Kevin. Oh boy, that's a big spin. Thanks, Boas, Breakthrough, Zach, everybody. That was a lot of fun. Oh wow, he just got on the gas way too hard. Then he looped it around. Where does the 22 come into play here? He did the same thing. Oh my god. That's gotta be the funniest thing I've seen in a while. Like, I feel bad, but that's just a comedy of errors right there. How did I set the force feedback wrong? It was just my fault. I set it way too high. I set it up so it was at full strength, and that's obviously just gonna kill the motor or the encoder, because it got way too hot and died, but that was before I knew how to set everything up correctly. That was a while ago. That was when I first got started with this, really. And yeah, it's set to 900 degrees in the profiler, but that's not how you set it up in the game. Like right here, it's 853 for me, although everybody's is a little different. You're never going to get exactly 900 when it's set up properly, but you should be able to get it pretty close, like I have there. It didn't appear to have any damage from that hit with the tire barrier. That was the only real incident I had all race. Yeah, I mean, I just barely clipped it with the right front fender. Actually, I'm not even really sure if that was an actual touch or if that was just netcode or something. I mean, I used to just set it up so it was 900 in game 2, but I later found out that was not the way it was supposed to be set up, and it actually... What it actually allowed me to do was have a more proper 1-to-1 ratio, and because of that I can actually save slides better than when I just set it to 900, because it's more exact now. Anywho, let's check the points. Wow, it's only 1:30. That was a very short race. .258, so I improved by 17 points. 55 iRating. 0 incidents, still Class A, 4.99. .1080, what wheel do you have that has a 1080 degrees of rotation?